Hi, I'm Cory Korkow, Associate Curator of European Art. With my colleague Stephen Harrison, we've worked on the reinstallation of the British Gallery, which you'll find totally transformed on your next visit to the museum. While you'll still find visitor favorites by artists like Turner, Lawrence, and Reynolds, the gallery now includes more than a dozen works of art that are new to the collection, recently conserved, or haven't been on view for decades, allowing us to tell some new stories, and I'd love to share a couple of those with you today. The reinstallation presented a major opportunity to bring together paintings, sculpture, and decorative arts. Stephen and I agreed that ideally the new space would integrate the fine and decorative arts, like they would have been in a home of the period. So we envisioned the British Gallery as one grand space inviting a dialogue between these objects. There are so many exciting changes, including the walls painted in the bold, historic blue-green color verditer. But today I want to focus on just one new dialogue between the two oldest works in the gallery, a 17th century portrait by Peter Lely and a wood carving by Grinling Gibbons. During the 18th century, the portrait of Mrs. Leneve was owned by the eccentric collector Horace Walpole. This watercolor shows it in his country house, Strawberry Hill. When the work entered Cleveland's collection in 1942, she looked very different, and in fact, she had been the subject of a scandalous makeover. The conventions of beauty for the 17th century were not those of the early 20th, and before the museum acquired the painting, a conservator gave Mrs. Leneve what we might call now a facelift. In particular, her bulging eyes, fleshy chin, wide forehead, and protruding lower lip were diminished. These features may have belonged to Mrs. Leneve, but they were also stylistically characteristic of portraits of the period. When the overpainting was removed, the sitter was restored to her original appearance. For the last 10 years, the west wall of the gallery has looked like this. And the following is the new installation, which includes a James Pascal mirror and a full-length portrait by Thomas Gainsborough and a full-length portrait by Thomas Lawrence. The Lely was restored a long time ago, but recent conservation allowed us to install master woodcarver Grinling Gibbons' late 17th century overmantel. Gibbons created this work around 1675 for Cassiobury Park, a country house in England, where he made limewood carvings for a suite of 10 reception rooms. The work in Cleveland's collection was originally installed in the green drawing room over a mantel, surrounding a mirror from a watercolor dating from the 19th century. The house was demolished in 1927 and the contents sold at auction. Gibbons's carvings are typically built up from two or three layers of limewood, with separately carved elements such as birds or fruit added on. The swags feature flowers, fruits, leaves, and nuts, all slightly larger than life-size. Conservators worked to identify the original arrangement of the carving, which had been separated into several pieces. They removed later additions to the work, surface coatings, and even fashioned new peas to fill empty pea pods. A water jet cutter was used to fashion a light and strong interlocking aluminum backing for each section so that the work can be more safely moved and easily installed, moved, and stored. The Gibbons now surrounds the Lely over the mantel, uniting these 17th century works in an arrangement typical for their period. The new British Gallery is our most ambitious reinstallation to date, and I'm so proud to be part of an amazing team of people committed to presenting the collection in fresh, provocative ways, taking risks, and challenging traditional ways of looking at these works of art, many more of which you can see by visiting the museum and online. Register for free admission at cma.org and look for a preview of the reinstallation online too. Thanks for listening.
Support the CMA Fund. Help us create transformative experiences through art for the benefit of all the people forever. Thank you.